This excerpt was taken from a Full and Bloom interview with producer-engineer Beau Hill. You can listen to the entire Warrant Dirty, Rotten, Filthy, Stinking Rich interview at fullandbloom.com. Did you record Janie's vocals any different than, say, how you recorded Stephen Piercy's? I know you had kind of a formula where you would make them run through it a few times.
Well, the way that that Stephen's voice came out was I knew exactly what to do to make his voice sound that way. With Janie, it was just beat the previous take. And like I told you before, I'd get three takes, start to finish. And then the next morning, I would come up and do the vocal comp before the band showed up, stealing the best from the three performances and creating one bionic performance, let's just call it. And then I'd play it to Janie and I'd say, so what do you think? And he said, nah, I can beat it. Okay, great. So we'd keep that one and then he'd go in and do three more. And then I just continue that process until everybody sat around and nodded their head and said, yeah, that's the one. And that's kind of how we did it. So I was always keeping the best performance and the best work from the previous day until we beat it. Similarly to the way we would cut rhythm section tracks. You know, keep one, try and beat it.
As far as his voice holding up, was he kind of a workhorse and could do it all day?
He was. Yeah, he was. He was a workhorse. And and as I remember, he always came in really prepared. I mean, he knew exactly what he wanted to do. And he was also good if I said, okay, that's great. Let's try this. And I maybe hum him an idea. He'd go, okay. And when it got really good was when he would sing something, I would make a suggestion. And in trying to implement my suggestion, he came up with something even better. That was the sweet spot working with Janie. Because it was both of us kind of pushing each other to take it up to the next notch. And with great frequency, he would take a germ idea that I would give him, and he would render it back to me only 10 times better than the idea I came up with in the first place.
And you did quite a bit of backing vocals like you did on Rat, correct?
Yeah.
And you guys would harmonize and do stuff like that, or how did that work?
I don't really remember. I mean, I don't believe that there was any controversy around any of that kind of stuff. And a lot of stuff Janie and I did together, because the idea is, you know, if you think about it like a classical orchestra, if you have three violins playing the exact same part, it's going to sound somewhat different. So if you have three guys singing the exact same line, you're actually kind of creating that fourth mystery composite voice.
Of course.
If that makes any sense.
Sure. Yeah. I wouldn't think there would be any controversy. I just assumed when I read it online, I mean, that's just part of your production at this point. Or I almost looked at it as like how you did the Rat guys where you just did stuff when they weren't around. I just looked at it as that's your production. That's part of the bonus of getting you as a producer.
Well, yeah, sometimes it was easier if I heard something. Sometimes it was just easier if I just went in and did it myself rather than me walk somebody else through it just for the mechanics of getting it on tape. You know, and sometimes Janie would have all the background parts that he wanted written. I mean, he knew what he wanted to do anyway. And so, okay, great, let's go. By contrast, the Warrant guides were very easy to work with as opposed to on occasions with the Rat guys. And we had some controversial issues, you know, around the guitar players and all that. Right. Swirling around.
Of course, I was going to ask you about that. Yeah, that's coming up. I'll bring that up.
Oh, okay.
But I'd also think by this point, I mean, you're an incredibly established and successful producer. The Rat guys, I think, got used to it because you guys both kind of launch your careers at the same time. So that's always going to breed some contempt.
To put it mildly.
Don't